The success of the Basics of Gracie Jiu-Jitsu instructional series, along with a free bonus tape, How to Handle Stand-Up Aggression, inspired hundreds of students to write me requesting this series on street self-defense. In these tapes, I'll show you how to handle real-life threatening attacks using our proven jiu-jitsu techniques and prepare you for the violent streets of the 90s. We will now review a variety of scenarios, some where you are the attacker, others where you're being attacked. When performed correctly, these secrets could drastically change the outcome of a fight. Sometimes during a confrontation, you feel that the person that you're arguing with deserves to get hit. Either he said too much or he's been pushing you around, and you said to yourself, well, this is it. This guy needs to get hit. You already said that to your mind. You already made up your mind that you want to hit that individual. Often enough, you feel like punching is the best thing to do. But unless you have the right technique and you know exactly how to move your body and throw the right weight into that punch, there's a serious chance that you're going to get yourself hurt. Because if you don't know how to punch correctly, remember that the bone structure on somebody's face is much harder than the bones on your hand. So if you don't hit him correctly with the right balance and everything, you could hurt your hand seriously. To avoid that, I would recommend that instead of hitting a person with a punch, you should use a open hand slap. This is how it works. You want to make sure that your arms are loose, hanging next to your body. The more relaxed, the better. Because as you let your arms relax and hang next to your body, you're going to be able to develop more momentum in the hit. Also, you might want to consider, how would you normally hit somebody today without looking at this explanation? You probably thought about hitting a person like this, and a variety of different kinds of strikes or whatever. This is what I would recommend you to do. Leave your arms hanging loose next to your body. And from this position here, the hand will sweep across like that. The hand should be very relaxed. If you do it right, you should feel the tingling of the blood towards your hand. The arm is relaxed. You're facing off with the individual here in front of you. And the hand will fly across this way. For practice purpose, you should draw an imaginary line at this height and let your hand just cruise across this way. Your hand will be loose, relaxed. That's the move you want. If you were to do this and gradually increase the speed of the movement, hand is right there where you want to be. So that's one good way for you to practice, so that you don't want to keep your arms stiff and try to hit the person on the face. That's not the idea. You want to be very relaxed. The more relaxed, the more momentum you acquire on this move. So let your arms kind of swing free for practice purpose until you understand exactly how the arms want to move. That's what you're looking for. So if you have to hit somebody, the hand is going from this position and do that. I almost draw a backwards C with my arm. My hand will go this way. You don't want to do this and that because it becomes too obvious. From this position, my hand would, it's a one continuous motion. Pull around like this. Either side. So the arm is real loose. It draws backwards and then come across. Be sure that you don't keep your arm stiff so that your hand ends next to the shoulder. That's not what you want. Let your whole body swing free as if you want to reach away, all the way. So not only gives you more reach, but the arm being relaxed. From here, either side, like that. Once you understand the mechanics of the hit, let me just make a touch up regarding where do you aim the slap. Boys, please. What you want to do is have a relaxed hand, as I said, and aim for the ear. You want to hit with the palm of your hand, flat on the ear. So the idea is to be here and just go bang with a slap on the ear. That's the plan. That's what you're looking for as a target. Relax the arm and go flat on the person's ear. Okay? Another situation is when the person comes up to you and start doing one of those moves and getting really close, pushing you back and forth, and you like to make him uncomfortable. It's like he's getting so close and pushing you back to his chest, which is a very common attitude sometimes. The guy say, hey, man, what's going on? What do you want to do? Moving like that. So if the person is getting too close like this, pushing you back, I'm too close for a slap. I don't have the angle that I want. So what I'd recommend you to do at this point is say, hey, why are you doing this to me? Talk from here, and from this angle, use an elbow strike instead. So move back a little bit. The idea is from if I'm here, And if the person gets real close, I want to put my hands on the chest like this, again with my arms and shoulders real loose, so that I can now swing the elbow hit and use that as a weapon. Instead of punching the person or slapping because now he's too close, you say, hey man, what's happening? I didn't do anything. And then, bing, hit him from here with the elbow. Be sure that your hand, when you hit, the hand is this way, so that the face of the bone is what's going to hit him. You don't want to keep your hand down so that the padded part of the arm is going to be striking the person. This is the move you want. As far as the speed goes, it's almost as if you're swinging the punch, but you want to bring your hand inward so that the elbow is what sticks out. So if the person is here, he comes up close to me like this, but I'm going to pick him cold and fresh. And the guy does this, doing this move, he says, hey, bang, and then you hit with this. That's the idea. So instead of just using your hand, feel free to pivot on the ball of your foot so that your body can spin around with that. So from this position here, I put my hands on the chest. I say, hey, what's going on? I put my hand here, relax my shoulders, and then swing with the whole body weight. Relax. Say, hey, why me? And then from here, the idea is to turn your whole body so that you can use the elbow strike with the weight of the body behind it. If the attacker is far away from you and you don't have a chance for a slap or an elbow hit because he's too far away, it's time for you to consider using a leg as a weapon. In this case, what you want to do here is that you want to kick at the knee or at the stomach, but never too much higher than that. So from this position, what I'd recommend is that you use the leg to something like this and eventually work on closing the gap. So if the person is here, I want to use the leg and then come in to wrap the person this way. On the other side, please. So from here, what you want to do is that you want to lift your leg and snap on the knee. Go for this. Safer to keep the kick towards the knee than to try to do too much high kicks because it's easier for him to grab your foot. So if the person is doing this in a fighting stance, what you want to do is that you want to use that leg and then come in to wrap him up. So you want to stay close with him. Then eventually work your way around to do the same kind of throwing that we talked about. Many people don't give the act of standing up the importance that they should. Often enough, when you try to get up, you might try to get up this way, which is not a very good and balanced way to do it, because you find yourself vulnerable to be pushed back. Or if you try to get up like this, the person could just nail you knee hit as you're getting up. So what I'd recommend is if you have to get up, either in a situation like this, it could be dangerous to you if the attacker is getting ready to, you know, jump on you at any moment, is to rest your hand on the ground in a very casual way like this, bring the knee and the foot as well as your hip slightly off the ground so that you can swivel your body, your leg underneath your body. That's what you want. And then stand up. So if I'm sitting down and I want to get up without giving the attacker a chance to throw me off balance, never do this move because you're very vulnerable to be pushed back. Rest in one hand and from here bring your leg back. Not only am I protecting myself, but also if he pushes me back, I have a very good and solid base here to prevent from falling down. The trick is to rest on one hand and let your leg rest on the ground. That's what I want. Very casual, very comfortable position for me. From this position, you should be able to lift your body off the ground. If your weight is resting on this arm, this leg should not be too far away. Otherwise, you will feel awkward and the leg is not going to have the flexibility that you need. Keep this leg slightly closer to your body and this hand on the ground. I'm looking at this, at the attacker in front of me here, and say, hey, what's happening, man? From here, I'm going to bring my knee under and plant myself in base. If he jumps on me, I'm ready for him. If he doesn't, I can now take care of business anywhere I want. Be sure that you don't keep your head up, because that's going to make it difficult for your leg and your hip to swing under your body. Put your head down and lift your hip up at the same, it's like a swivel motion. Oh, that's what I want. To return to the position, it's the same thing. Plant your hand on the ground and just let your leg fold under.
It's a very easy position, especially if you can find yourself in this balance from here. If you need it, if the person is becoming very aggressive towards you, you can actually kick him away and bring your leg under.
Kick and bring the happy knees if you had to.
If you're on the ground and the attacker starts to move around, you want to keep your feet always towards him so that you can keep him away. You don't want to stay here and let him walk around towards your back, because now, once again, you're vulnerable for him to kick and jump and grab you from behind. So you want to make sure that you're doing this rocking motion with the arms relaxed, just holding my, helping my body up. And as he walks around, I'm always turning. My arms are relaxed. My body will carry the legs, and the legs will carry the body. So that's the move. I'm always like this. Oh. If you keep a very low, your body very low, it becomes very tiring on your stomach. You want to make sure that you sit all the way up, because that will help you to rest your stomach in the middle of the motion. So that's the move. The idea is to do this. So sit all the way up and then come down. That's what you want. Always with your feet following him. So that as you walk up and down, my elbows could be helping me up. Very relaxed at this point. So I'm here. The moment that I feel the time is right for me to get up, I want to kick that man away and stand up. So from here, he's all around. If he ever gets too close to me, I can always use the leg kicking towards his chin. That's what I want to do. If he moves away, I now have the distance that I need to stand up and down in the right base again. My friends, I'm confident that these techniques will help you in a street fight. I want to thank Royce. See you next time.